Take your time.
I think what saved me was when I went into the hospital that night.
Clinton Bradley is a Navy veteran who suffers from PTSD. In 2005, he was in such emotional distress, Bradley tried to end his life.
I had taken a handful of sleeping pills, and she chased it with some vodka, and by the time we ended up, and I lost consciousness.
Bradley's trauma is not the result of his service, but started long before when he was a child, a gay boy living in a strict Christian household.
The things that were always said to me were, gays should be shipped off to a deserted island and blow it up. If I ever knew one of my kids were gay, I'd throw them in a closet with a Bible, lock it, and I'd shoot their lover.
Bradley suppressed his feelings until he came out of that closet his senior year at Hillsdale Free Will Baptist College.
When I came out to my parents in Bible college, the first words out of my father's mouth was, "I'd rather hear you're dead than gay."
Bradley had two options, get kicked out of school and kicked out of his family, or go through conversion therapy. Bradley chose the latter and tried several different faith-based programs to cure him of what he was told was his sinful behavior.
It makes you feel like you don't know who you are. They definitely let you know that those feelings are never going to go away. What they let you know is that there are practices in place, almost like Alcoholics Anonymous. There are practices that are in place that you can do to basically suffocate the feelings.
Is there any way that conversion therapy can work?
No. No.
I remember on my 18th birthday, after I got a bunch of piercings and a tattoo and I was bald, and I walked into my mom's house and I said, "Mom, don't I look like a boy?" And she grabbed me by the face and she said, "You can never be a boy, you'll always be my beautiful baby."
Until 12 years ago, Amanda Smith identified as a lesbian, also questioning her gender.
I know what it feels like to be in a woman's body and feel uncomfortable in that body and ask the Lord, "Did you make a mistake? Like, did you make a mistake?" And I also know that he absolutely did not make a mistake.
When Smith became a Christian, she became conflicted about her sexual orientation and gender identity. With the help of Desert Stream Ministries, Smith says her attraction to women has diminished.
I was obviously living in that lifestyle, had girlfriends. Now I live a chaste life with the help of the Holy Spirit. I don't ever believe, I don't shake my hand at the heaven and say, "God, you have to take this away from me or else."
So do you see your former life as a sinful life?
I do. And not just my sexuality, everything else.
We're actually not a conversion therapy organization.
Abby Ford is the executive director of Desert Stream Ministries, which she says is not a therapeutic organization, but a prayer ministry that equips people who struggle with their sexuality and other issues to walk with the Lord.
We're looking at it as kind of a fundamental brokenness related to God's created vision for mankind. And so when we're working with people, we're saying, "All right, this is something you desire." And so we're going to walk, in our case, we do a 20-week group where we're talking, teaching, praying, speaking on the various topics actually that contribute to our brokenness.
The goal is to get you to uncover lies, what you believe about yourself and your identity, and also the lies that I believe about who God is and what he says about me. I can tell you now, I am comfortable in my body. I still struggle from time to time, but I'm comfortable with my body. I say it's good that God made me a woman.
Conversion therapy is an incredibly harmful practice.
Steph Perkins is the executive director of PROMO, Missouri's statewide LGBTQ advocacy organization.
When we're using this practice that has no scientific backing against young people who are forming into adults and who are trying to figure out who they are and are seeking support from the people they love, and this causes a lifetime of damage. And so this is our hope to change that.
In 2007, the American Psychological Association formed a task force to study sexual orientation change efforts, concluding they are unsuccessful and dangerous. Since then, 15 states have drafted laws banning conversion therapy of minors by licensed medical professionals. And due to the separation of church and state, Faith-based organizations like Desert Stream Ministries are not affected. A similar bill is being considered in Jefferson City, called the Youth Mental Health Preservation Act.
And I think once we start getting those laws out there and it's an understanding, it helps the community in driving out these pseudo-counseling things that are going on within these faith-based organizations.
But what do you say to people who are comfortable with it and want to live their life that way?
Sure. I would say that we are all free to choose. We are all free to choose